Hi, and welcome to Bedford TV News for a special edition on today, Monday, March 16th. I'm shooting live right now my time, which is about 2 o'clock p.m., just to keep you notified of what time and the date for any updates that are going on with the COVID-19 crisis right now. I am in my dining room. We are home at the studio right now. Things are closed and shut down, so we are, as a team, compiling together the news to bring to you with all the updates that are going on. So again, I'm Jen Pula, and thank you for all of you that are watching today on Monday, March 16th. I have a teleprompter above me, which is like two computers, so in case I'm looking up, that's why. So just just go with it with the makeshift studio in my kitchen right now. The news will repeat on Wednesday and Friday, as it usually does, on Verizon Channel 38 and Comcast Channel 8 at 6 p.m., and you can always watch us on YouTube at youtube.com/BedfordTVMA. As always, thank you to the Bedford Citizen for providing the source of our news for today and always. So updates that I'm reading to you right now are basically in sequential order, so make sure that you stick with me for the whole way through to see what the latest updates are as of, like, 2 o'clock today. So the governor has declared a state of emergency in Massachusetts due to COVID-19. Governor Charlie Baker announced on Sunday evening, March 15, 2020, that all bars and restaurants in Massachusetts would be shut down to on-premise consumption beginning Tuesday, March 17, 2020, through April 6, 2020. This order allows bars and restaurants to continue to offer food for takeout or delivery. The order does not apply to grocery stores or pharmacies. Large gatherings of over 25 people are banned in an effort to stem the coronavirus outbreak in the Commonwealth. This order includes all community, civic, public, leisure, faith-based events, as well as sports games with spectators, concerts, and conventions. It also covers fitness centers, private clubs, and theaters. There will be a 3-week suspension for all public and private schools effective Tuesday, March 17, 2020, and they will not be open before Monday, April 6th of 2020. The 3-week suspension of school operations for educational purposes at all public and private elementary and secondary K-12 schools in the Commonwealth does not include residential and day schools for special needs students. Suspension of educational programming would not necessarily affect the availability of school buildings for the provision of food or other essential non-educational services. As April 6 approaches, the governor's administration will provide additional guidance. As such, Bedford Public Schools will be closed until April 6, 2020, or until further guidance is provided. The district will monitor the public health situation as it evolves. During this period, it is critical that students and their families, as well as school staff, stay home as much as possible. If an individual needs to leave the home, it is essential to strictly follow social distancing guidelines by avoiding crowds, canceling social gatherings, and maintaining a safe separation of at least 6 feet from others. I'm just noticing how far away I am from my teleprompter operator, who's my son. Restricting access to school buildings will have little impact on public health if these best practices are not followed in good faith. The suspension of educational operations at K-12 schools will inevitably affect the provision of preschool and child care services. Although the Commonwealth is not ordering the closure of child care programs at this time, they are strongly urging child care providers to strictly observe guidelines that are being issued by the Department of Early Education and Care, the EEC, and by the Department of Public Health, which call for temporary closures based on actual direct or indirect exposures to individuals with COVID-19. Nursing homes, assisted living facilities, and long-term care providers must ban visitors with an exception for end-of-life providers. Hospitals must postpone non-medically urgent surgeries. Drugstores will have the ability to make and sell their own hand sanitizer. You're not supposed to have a dry throat, actually, through this whole thing. I've been reading a lot to get this caught up, so bear with me a sec. Being an example of what you're supposed to be doing. Drink a lot of water. Bedford's COVID-19 task force will be meeting with Economic Development Director Alyssa Sandoval to begin outreach to our local proprietors to ensure we can help support their businesses during this time of closure. So, a more recent update, the Town of Bedford COVID-19 Task Force met on Sunday to review the latest guidance from the Department of Public Health, the DPH, the Office of Governor Charlie Baker, and Town Legal Counsel. Sorry for the bips, I forgot to shut off my Google Hangouts. And the Office of Governor Charlie Baker and Town Legal Counsel. The COVID-19 Task Force is compromised of the following town officials: Sarah Stanton, Town Manager; John Sills, Superintendent of Schools; Heidi Porter, Director of Health and Human Services; Robert Bongiorno, the Police Chief; and David Grunes, Fire Chief; and Tasir Alani, Facilities Director. As of yesterday, March 15, 2020, there are 3 presumptive positive cases of COVID-19 in the town of Bedford and 1 person under investigation. The task force is actively monitoring the quarantine close contacts of the 3 presumptive positive cases, and if they report applicable symptoms, which are fever, shortness of breath, cough, chills, etc., they will be directed to contact their health care provider. Anyone exhibiting flu-like symptoms should immediately self-quarantine, isolate from household members, and contact their health care provider for further guidance on whether testing is warranted. So the town and schools are asking for kindness to be spread throughout all of this. As the town of Bedford navigates the uncertainty and challenges of COVID-19, town and school officials would like to implore residents to remember the value and importance of kindness and civility. Bedford is a community known for its committed and engaged residents, exceptional schools, and neighborhood camaraderie. And now more than ever is the time to be a good neighbor. Support one another. Check in on the elderly and immune compromised. Call your loved ones and your neighbors and check up on their mental and physical health. Assist with technology, like I'm doing right now. The use of technology will be more important than ever as we practice social distancing. You can teach a family member or neighbor a new skill, as long as you keep your 6-foot distance. How to pay bills online, using mobile options for games like Mahjong or crossword puzzles, and teach the joy of video chat capabilities. FaceTime and Skype can be a wonderful way to share a little laughter when you're homebound. And if you want something longer, you can use QuickTime, like I'm using right now. Over the past week, it has been wonderful to see the spirit of volunteerism of residents offering to deliver food, provide emotional support, and share words of encouragement, solidarity, and optimism. It's been equally as disheartening to see unkind sentiments directed towards specific groups within our community and the family first impacted by this pandemic in Bedford. As a town, we're better than that. We're kinder. We're more compassionate, and we're more empathetic. Now is the time to show each other what makes Bedford such a wonderful place to live and to work. We're in this together. Be kind to one another. So an update later on the evening, yesterday, March 15th, town officials continued to urge residents to deploy social distancing and limit social gathering. Residents are urged to not congregate at restaurants, bars, malls, or recreation spaces. We have another update after that, so hold on to questions you might have. You can order takeout, you can get your coffee to go, pick up a gift certificate, and support the local business communities from a distance. To ensure our residents and small businesses in Bedford impacted by COVID-19 are supported during this tumultuous time, the town of Bedford will be establishing an emergency relief fund. Stay tuned over the next several days for guidance on how to donate. As of yesterday, March 15, 2020, Town Hall and Town Center remain open to the public during normal business hours. They anticipate closing town buildings to the public at large effective Tuesday, March 17, 2020, to ensure the safety of our residents and town staff. As the buildings will be operating with reduced staffing today, Monday, March 16, 2020, prior to entering Town Hall or Town Center, a police officer will ask residents and visitors questions relative to COVID-19. They'll ask if you've traveled in the list of countries identified by the CDC as high risk. They'll ask if you've been in close contact with a person deemed presumptive positive, and if you are showing flu-like symptoms. If the answer is yes to any of the aforementioned questions, the person will not be allowed to enter the building and will be advised to return home and quarantine. The town strongly encourages the public to limit physical visits to town buildings, if not critical. Call or email. Staff will be available to answer questions. And effective Monday, March 16th, all town-owned playgrounds, parks, and athletic fields will be closed to the public as the town continues to reinforce the importance of social distancing and the public health damage created by social gatherings. Town officials struggled to see so many of the athletic fields and playgrounds heavily used by families over this past weekend. Under normal circumstances, a sure sign of spring would be kids and families holding batting practice at our baseball fields and swinging side by side at our parks. Understanding the need for fresh air and recreation, the town is recommending residents deploying social distancing take advantage of our comprehensive trail system. However, please do not coordinate small or large group hikes. The town is working closely to ensure the Bedford Food Pantry remains open. Sorry, there was no segue there. Food pantry. The town will work with the food pantry board and manager and offered to have youth and family services personnel to staff the pantry. The Ashby Place food pantry will continue as scheduled with food drop-off instead of pick-up. And as so many kind-hearted residents have asked if they can donate drop-off food to the Bedford Food Pantry, the town encourages residents at this time to donate monetarily to the website, which is bedfordfoodpantry.org/content/donate. That's bedfordfoodpantry.org/content/donate. As the town cannot ensure the safety of food dropped off, we would encourage monetary donations as a way to assist those in need. Working with our partners at the Bedford Public Schools, the town will be stocking the food pantry with several bulk orders placed through the Bedford Public Schools food services vendor. Over the next few days, the town will announce plans to deliver food to homebound residents in need and establish a drive-up system for residents who are able to leave their home. The town has established an internal emergency management account to track the municipal expenses and labor costs related to COVID-19 management. As there has not been guidance provided by federal or state leadership on emergency relief funding, the town has proactively created the fund to account for expenses related to this pandemic. The town urges reasonable caution and strongly urges all residents practice good hygiene, especially as it relates to hand washing and covering coughs and sneezes. The town has stated and continues to advise that those, including municipal employees, residents, or students, who are feeling sick with fever or flu symptoms, should stay home, self-quarantine, not report to work or school, and contact their medical provider to determine if they should be tested for COVID-19. For previous updates on COVID-19, please review the COVID-19 news and announcements page at the town website, which is bedfordma.gov. I realize, like, when you're normally anchoring, can you pause a second? At least Dawn gets to talk, or Anne, when you're talking nonstop, it's a lot. Okay. Continuing, all local actions are being undertaken in accordance with the latest guidelines from the Massachusetts Department of Public Health and the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, the CDC. It's important to remember that while the COVID-19 outbreak is evolving quickly, influenza is currently circulating in the area. Many of the things you do to help prevent colds and the flu can help protect you against other respiratory viruses. Wash your hands often with soap and warm water for at least 20 seconds. Avoid touching your eyes, nose, and mouth. Clean things that are frequently touched, like doorknobs and countertops, with household cleaning sprays or wipes. Cover your mouth when you cough or sneeze. Use a tissue or your inner elbow, not your hands. Stay home if you are sick and avoid close contact with others. Employ social distancing if you are not otherwise required to be in quarantine and must go out. The best source of guidance and recommendations is the DPH website, which is mass.gov/COVID-19. COVID-19. There's no hyphen. Thank you. Or if you are without internet capabilities, you can call the state hotline, which is 211. I want to thank my son, by the way, Maxwell Goldman, for helping right now. Oh, shoot. Sorry. There's the phone. Sorry. So pick it up and then hit end. Okay. Sorry about that. That's live TV. Okay. So you can also look at the Bedford website for local updates and actions, which is bedfordma.gov. Sorry if I just said that. Town and school officials in the Bedford Health Department remain in continuous communication about this issue, and further updates will be provided to the community as we receive them. Hopefully that wasn't one just now, but I will check it as soon as I'm done. So, switching on to brighter news, we had a town election this past Saturday on Pi Day. Happy belated Pi Day to all of you. On Saturday, March 14th, the town of Bedford successfully held the annual municipal election. Drumroll, 1,240 voters cast ballots representing 12.3% of the 10,104 registered voters. All precincts voted at the John Glenn Middle School. Polls opened at 8 a.m. and closed at 6 p.m. So here are the winners. I have a mic, by the way, over here. It's just like it's foam. It's not real. So I'm just going to keep that here. Polls opened at 8 a.m. The winners, incumbent Edward M. Pierce and challenger Bopa Malone, were elected in the town's only competitive race. Both will serve 1 3-year term on Bedford's Board of Selectmen. Rebecca Neal will serve 1 3-year term on the Board of Assessors. Anne A. Kiesling and Susan Burrish Schwartz will serve 1 3-year term on the Board of Health. Stephen R. Hagen and Jacinda M. Barbahan will serve 1 3-year term on the Planning Board. Robin Grace Silbert and Rachel Field will serve 1 3-year term as Library Trustees. Sarah Scoville and Anne Guay will serve 1 3-year term on School Committee. J. Bradley Morrison will serve 1 2-year term on School Committee. Daniel Hartley Brosgill will serve 1 1-year term on School Committee. The town of Bedford also voted yes on all 8 ballot questions on Election Day. Thanks to the tireless efforts of town staff, poll workers, and public safety personnel, Election Day was a success. Thank you to interim town clerk Rosemary Harville and her staff members Ashley Cote and Ashley Large for managing an exceptionally difficult day with grace and competence. An extra special thanks to town employees Sharon Cozy, Colleen Doyle, Lynn Newhouse, Marsha Piles, Alyssa Sandoval, and Charlie Tukotsky for helping staff the election on short notice. The election would not have taken place without the support of the town's hardy and trusted poll workers, dedicated municipal facilities department staff, and the leadership of public safety personnel. Congratulations to the newly elected town officials. And here's hoping the next election is a bit easier for all involved. Okay, that was a lot to say. Thank you for bearing with my phone calls and Google Hangout alerts. And we're going to shoot it on over to weather now with Paul. Over to you, Paul.
Good evening, Bedford. My name's Paul, and here's a look at the weather for this week. Today was nice and sunny and cool, but high near 38. Unfortunately, some of this week looks like it's going to be wetter and more active. Tonight, we'll see increasing clouds with a low around 30. Tomorrow, on Tuesday, there's a chance of snow showers in the morning, and then it'll be raining most of the rest of the day, with a high around 47. There shouldn't be any snow accumulation, though. Tuesday night, we'll see gradual clearing with a low around 32. Then Wednesday, that's the pick of the week. It'll be sunny with a high near 50. On Wednesday night, though, there's a chance of showers overnight, with a low around 32. Then Thursday, it'll be rainy all day, possibly mixed with snow showers. The high will be near 47. Thursday night will be cloudy with showers continuing and a low around 42. On Friday, the rain showers will continue on and off all day. And also, it'll be windier as a warm front moves through. Believe it or not, the high will be up around 70. Then on Friday night, the showers will wind up by midnight and there'll be partial clearing with a low around 41. Saturday will be partly sunny with a high near 50, but the gusty winds will continue. Saturday night will be partly cloudy with a low around 26. Then Sunday will be completely sunny with a high near 44. Sunday night will continue to be clear with a low around 26. Then Monday should be mostly sunny again with a high near 50. So that's the weather for the week ahead. Back to you, Jen.
Thanks so much, Paul, for the weather update. For Bedford TV News, I am Jen Pula. And thank you so much for watching, and make sure that you stay tuned to your local channels, to your email, and you can take a look for updates at thebedfordcitizen.org for more information. So we'll see you next week. Be safe, everyone. Bye-bye.